Peeves the Portuguese has appeared in all Harry Potter books, along with the first three video games, but none of the films. It was the scene with Peeves was filmed in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, but was left on the catamaran floor. So in this video, I'm gonna explain Peeves' origins, along with his first appearance, and all the way to his last appearance in the books. Peeves has lived at Hogwarts Castle since its founding in the year 993. He came with the building and came into existing with the founding, institution containing a large number of children. It was cast that Peeves is a tangible manifestation of the students' mischief. Peeves has wrought havoc upon Hogwarts for centuries and was often the cause of ire for various teachers and staff. Peeves is the most notorious and troublesome Portuguese in British history, unlike the overwhelming majority of his colleagues. Peeves has a physical form, though he is able to become invisible at will. He could also affect solid objects. Unlike the ghosts, he could be affected by magic. The Bloody Baron was the only being that Peeves took orders from. Peeves had a large amount of respect for the Bloody Baron for unknown reasons, likely because he was very much afraid of him. Apart from the Bloody Baron, Albus Dumbledore was the only being in Hogwarts who Peeves was known to have shown any respect for, which was likely out of fear that Dumbledore could have him expelled from Hogwarts. 1991 school year. Harry, Ron and Hermione once again encountered Peeves in the hallways during their quest to save the Philosopher's Stone. Without Peeves' knowledge, the three of them were concealed under Harry's invisibility cloak, from which Harry impersonated the Bloody Baron, warning Peeves to stay away from the third floor that night, which was enough to frighten him away and avoid being caught by them during this mission. 1992 school year. Peeves attended Nearly Headless Nick Dead Day Party. He informed Myrtle that Hermione was talking behind her back, so Myrtle ran off crying, and Peeves enjoyed her pain. Sometimes later, Peeves appeared in the hallway with Harry, where he noticed the two new basilisk victims, Justine Finch-Flitley and Nearly Headless-Nick. He loudly alerted the faculty and students of Hogwarts of the attack. He performed a song to laugh at Harry over the fact the student thought he was the one releasing Slytherin's monster and petrifying the Muggle-born students. 1993 school year. Peeves appeared before Remus Lupin in his third year defense against the dark arts class, when they were entering the teacher's class for a particular lesson. Peeves stuffed a keyhole with chewing gum. Professor Lupin asked him to remove the gum, but Peeves refused, so Remus cast a simple spell, which shot the gum up Peeves' nose. On 31 October, Peeves informed Professor Dumbledore of the fat lady's location after her portrait was attacked. He also revealed that her attacker was the escaped prisoner Sirius Black. 1994 school year. His first appearance was before the welcoming feast in the entrance hall, where he dropped water balloons on the students during the feast. When Harry was practicing the summoning charm with Hermione, Peeves appeared and started chucking cheers across the room. Around the time of the Yellow Ball, Peeves frequently hid in a suit of armor and sang rude songs, and was also accused of stealing Harry's golden egg. That night Harry worked out the clue. 1995 school year. Peeves was not completely without loyalties. Though during Dolores Umbridge's attempt to take control of Hogwarts, he showed respect for his fellow troublemakers Fred and George Weasley, taking their part in war to give Umbridge hell to heart as they fled the school. This marked possibly the only time Peeves not only obeyed any students. It appears that Peeves was actually on friendly terms with the strict Professor McGonagall during this time due to Umbridge, and apparently she later allowed him to borrow her walking stick to hit Dolores as she fled from Hogwarts. 1996 school year. When Harry asked Luna Lovegood to attend Professor Slughorn's party, Peeves overheard and started singing a song of his own, describing the situation. When Harry Potter was admitted to the hospital wing after suffering a cracked skull when he was hit by the bludger, Harry summoned Creature to have him tell Draco Malfoy around the castle. Creature apparated there along with Dobby, with whom he was fighting after Creature assaulted Harry Potter. A moment later, Peeves apparated, saying that he was watching the fight. Then Peeves egged them on verbally, then throwing chalk at them to enrage them further. In April 1997, after attending the funeral of Aragog and getting an important memory from Horace Slughorn, Harry Potter could feel the effect of Felix Felicis wearing off. As he escaped back into the castle, he encountered Peeves but managed to escape detection by taking a shortcut. It is unknown and never mentioned if Peeves attended Dumbledore's funeral, but in my opinion, I think Peeves would love to be there. During the Battle of Hogwarts, Filch invited Peeves to take part in defense of the castle. Peeves showed that despite his endless mischiefs, he was loyal to Hogwarts and willingly participated. He caused pain to the Death Eaters and did not harm the fighters on Hogwarts' side. Peeves witnessed Voldemort find a defeat at the hand of Harry Potter. After the battle, he was heard singing a victory song to celebrate winning the battle.